Darius Bradley. I'm Megasci Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
I'm Dejon Hall, and I'm a brother of Iota Phi Theta Fraternity Incorporated.
I'm part of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated.
This is Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated.
I am a member of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated.
I am a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated.
Jaren C. Mitchell, Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated.
I'm a member of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated.
That's my sorority run yard.
Be honest. Hey,
I feel that we do.
Turn my swag up. We the bros. And if you ain't know, you better know. You better ask about us, because we run the yard.
That's not really a question. Yeah, we run the yard.
Do we run the yard?
Do you? Yeah.
Do I run the yard?
Does your organization run the yard?
I think I run the yard.
No, does your organization?
But we run the yard.
Does your frat run the yard here on this campus?
I think so.
Yeah.
Because you know what I'm saying? I mean, every probate. Shots, it don't matter. It's shots at us all the time. I mean, whatever you go, but I mean, it's all fun,
it's
man.
All
but
fun,
I mean,
man.
I feel like we do run the yard though, so.
I don't think anybody runs the yard. I think it's just pure entertainment. It should stay that way.
All right, so look, it's a problem with this whole Greek stuff here on this yard, though. Like, I'm having a problem with it, like, to tell you the truth. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
What's the problem? Why don't we get along? Why don't Divine Nine get along?
Because egos, too many people, man, they let us make them instead of making letters, man.
At Winston State University, I feel that there's a division because I feel people lack knowledge, lack discipline.
Respect.
Yeah, respect, basically. Respect for themselves, respect for others, respect for a foundation. If people, particularly people in Greek letter organizations, understood the principles that their organization was founded upon, and they would truly understand that this isn't a game type thing.
I mean, certain members, but as a whole, probably not.
Yeah, why, certain. Why you think that?
I mean, when competition comes, you know what I'm saying? Yeah,
it
competition comes, attitude, man. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Say it again.
It turns into being personal.
Yeah.
You know, other being all funny games, it's real personal, you know.
I don't think if you didn't hang out before you got in the organization,
right,
you're probably not going to be friends right now, because it's deeper than that.
There is some Greek unity. It could always be better. But I would say it's better than most campuses, because some campuses you don't have, you know, the Zetas that'll talk to the Deltas, or the Qs that'll talk to the Sigmas. So it's kind of like that, but it can always be better, but I think it's getting there.
I don't think anyone gets along because everyone, of course, we're different organizations, so you kind of cliquish, and no one wants to step outside of the box and be the one to, like, kind of do something together. So, I mean, everybody's just doing their own thing. I don't think there's a problem or whatever amongst the organizations, but I think everybody's just doing their own thing.
I think it's safe to say that 80% of the Greek population on Winston State University's campus does not uphold the principles of that organization. And the only way that it can be any type of change is, you know, if we feel that change, then that'll be changed. Like, if we put into that fire, then there'll be change. Like, if you're not doing nothing, don't expect nothing.
So what's the problem here? Why? How come we have yet to see some kind of joint anything between Gamma Phi and Gamma Lambda?
What's up with Gamma Lambda and Gamma Phi?
Honestly, I think...
Honest.
I don't really know what the problem is with that, but ever since, like, we got back, Gamma Lambda was off the yard for about 5 years, and so I guess they were mad when we came back because they were running the yard or something.
Are they still running the yard now?
No, they're not. So I guess they were upset because when we came back really hard with programs and community service, doing stuff for the students here on campus. So I don't know if they feel threatened by that, but we would love to do something with Gamma Phi, even when we tried to do a stroll with them for the stroll off the cure with the Iotas. They didn't want to participate with that. So there's been times where we reached out to do stuff and, like, there hasn't been a response.
I think both sides are caught up in the hype of being rivals.
Right.
And maybe we just need to set our differences aside, just because maybe one organization, it's a, what is it? Possibly didn't have a process or whatever, and you put that aside.
Right.
Because as long as you do for your organization, I think that's okay.
True.
But also with that, some people just don't have like respect for their own organization. When you don't have respect for your own organization, you don't have respect for everybody else in the shows. Right. So that's what Gamma Lambda and Gamma Phi's problem is.
Give me your honest opinion. You think we get along?
Heck
don't
no.
Cuss. Do you think that we get along? Give me your honest opinion.
No.
I think that they're like more popular fraternities and sororities compared to like some of the other ones. And so it seems like they kind of don't get along as well as they should.
Oh yeah, I know AKA's Delta's got beef, and I know the Alphas and the Q's got beef. I mean, and it's supposed to be like that, but it's supposed to be in all good spirit.
Right.
But I have yet to see any of that good part come out.
How do you think?
I don't think there's no great unity. Like when I go to certain things and all the Greeks are there, like there's like it's people that I know they're friends with other Greeks.
Right.
Like, cause like maybe like an Alpha's friend with a Q or something like that. But like the organization as a whole,
right,
there's no like no kind of bonding.
I think we need to first clear up the misconception that I don't believe that there's dislike between the Greeks. I believe there are individuals within the Greeks that dislike one another. So it's not necessarily Greek versus Greek, but actual individuals who dislike an individual within another organization.
Well, it's really quite simple. What happens, you know, you always have your regular people and the not so cool people and everything like that. And when they finally become Greek, then it's like, now I am the campus and I run the campus. And you know, people just, I don't want to say they get brand new, they just change, you know, right. and it's never for the good for some people.
In some cases, I have seen a change, like not a lot of people. It seems like it's a minority of people who change, so to speak, but you can notice like a difference for when they join and then when they do. It's like they don't want to hang out with everybody.
Right.
It seems like different that
way. Do you think that's for a good thing or a bad thing, depending on, you know?
I think it's a bad thing because you should never let your organization make you. You should make the organization.
I don't think it's, you know what I'm saying, we up here and they down there. I just think that with us doing whatever we had to do to be a part of our organization, we cut out some of the other, you know what I'm saying, mess.
Church.
You know what I mean? So with that, you know what I mean, the regular students, they still doing their fun and games and stuff, but I'm about my business at the end of the day. So I'm going to do what I have to do. I might not, you know what I'm saying, go sit on the breezeway and rap with everybody. I might have something else I got to do. Right. So I'm busy. So too much is going through my mind to be a regular student right now.
And what organization are you a part of?
I am a member of Kappa Kappa Psi National Honorary Band Fraternity Incorporated.
I'm in Phi Mu Alpha Symphonia Fraternity of America Incorporated.
Okay.
Mu Beta Chapter.
There is a division between CIGO and NPAC. Well, in my honest opinion, I see it as, it's been a lot of disrespect between everybody. Pretty much, I think before the whole Divine Nine got back, you know, KK Psi, TBS, which are, you know, everybody view as CIGO themselves, you know, Cal Alpha Phi, some of the other organizations are in that. But, you know, KK Psi, TBS have always wanted to be, in a good sense, I say involved. And then on the NPAC side, everybody view it as, you know, it's NPAC, so y'all can't be in that. And then a lot of just immature stuff just got involved. So I think that's why we have a divide now.
Do you feel that there is a division between the two? I think there is.
Yeah, feel there? I feel
that it
is. Why? I sense it. I don't know why. I think it comes from the perception of that CIGO aren't real fraternities.
Do you feel some kind of way when we say, if any Divine Nine organization comes up to you and say, man, you're not Greek, man. We the real, like.
Well, I'd be mad as heck. And then I would tell them, I was like, we were born before you were because we're from 1898.
Right.
You know.
Personally, I just feel like, for my organization, speaking on behalf of my organization, I'm going to be honest. We're tired of being treated like real less. Like hearing KK Psi is not a real fraternity. Or hearing, they're non-Greek when, like, clearly Kappa Kappa and Psi are three Greek letters.
Right.
To be put in a category that we're less, or that since we're not in the Divine Nine, or that we were started by 10 white men,
right,
that we're less of an organization. We work hard. We serve, right. And we just want to be treated fairly. Not in a sense that we don't want to be treated as if, like I said, we're less. But we want to be able to, if we want to compete or struggle or work with another organization, that we're not looked down upon like a little brother or a less of an organization.
I understand that they want to be a part of it, but they got to understand, like, they're a little late on the rap sheet, you know what I mean? They can come to the step show, they can step, you know what I'm saying, as an exhibitionist, but at the same time, this is divine right here. You see how we in the circle right here. We all looking at each other.
Right.
You got to go away to see them.
Right.
You know what I mean? And not to disrespect their organization, because it's strong, you know. I like to skate myself, and I wish I'd, you know what I mean, at your heart, but at the same time, you know what I mean? Not welcome right now.
Why don't they have a CIGO show off? Why don't they have that?
Right.
It shouldn't just be solely up to NPHC. Like, you want to be, like, if you want people to know your organization, why don't you do stuff with CIGO so y'all can get more recognized?
I totally agree. And to me, I only see that on the campus of Winston-Salem State University. When you go to other universities, never do you see CBS, KKSI, or any other organizations trying to participate in Penn, Hellenic Council, like, stuff. So it's just on this campus. I don't know where that came from.
The angle we came from is it didn't read Panhellenic Step Show. It read WSSU Homecoming Step Show.
Yeah.
Or WSSU Spring Step Show.
Yeah.
And since it's a WSSU event and we are students here on the community, we felt we should be granted the same opportunity to step or stroll, showcase our talents and abilities, and compete for money.
I mean, I don't even think if they're not a part of Divine Nine, then why are you trying to get in?
That's
you know what I'm saying?
Right. I think KKSI wants to step so bad, because I think they're the ones who brought up the whole issue of stepping in a step show.
Right.
I think they want to step because, one, they're good at it, and two, we never have, like, a step show. So, I mean, I think there should be exhibition, but to say that they could be in the competition, like, up there with the money for grass, nah. I don't think that.
I just feel like if they just want to be a part, and... But they gotta understand where stuff started at. I mean,
they tell it, and you know, one of them, they've actually said, well, we started before y'all.
So what?
You're.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? I like, you start letting them get into it, then you know what I'm saying? You're gonna let the choir organization get into it, and you know, Alpha Omega wanna get a little piece of it, and then everybody trying to get into it, and then it's gonna be a whole melee, and then the nursing organization gonna try to get in. And then you know, just keep it right here with
those shots for real.
Yeah, just keep it up here on the concrete where the original plot set. So,
but look, keep it
you know, we don't need
keep it on
that
a positive
stuff.
Note. If they do want to be partaking in any step show, they need to be part
they
of
have,
the
they can have
they need to go to the national pan council. You know,
I tell you a better
one. Hey,
tell you, better. They can have a step show. They can have it over there in Dilla.
Yeah, have a.
You know what I'm saying?
COG.
And
I think they should really be individuals because you're part of CIGO for a reason.
Right.
And we're NPHC for a reason.
Right.
We're not, neither one is better. You should, if you're an individual, you would stand for your organization and you wouldn't want to try to be a part of anything else.
How about the freshmen trying to step and.
Like, be honest, like,
march out like frats. Like.
Yes, I've heard of the freshman step team.
Have you heard of the freshman step team?
Don't want
step. Have you heard of the freshman step team?
Yeah.
you heard about the freshman step team?
Yes, I did.
You heard of the freshman step team?
Yeah, I heard.
Have you heard of the little freshman step team?
Yeah, they performed at a basketball game recently. I thought that was cute.
Have you heard of the freshman step team?
I saw the freshman step team.
First quote, what do you think about them first? Honest.
From what I saw.
Honest.
Warn them out, let's go. Hey look, show me on JLC, Black ENT shouter, get it. And I'm right now, about to introduce y'all to some of the coolest cats I ever met from the Midwest. Hot style them. They said, Jock, we need to have a roasting session. You and us, we go at it, do it for the world. It's so wait, nobody ever did it before. Let's go. I said I'm with it if you with it. Warn them out.
Some, you know, some fraternities and sororities, you know, they have a big problem with that.
Why?
You tell me.
I totally don't agree with that. Don't get me wrong, I'm fine with the freshman step off. If you want to compete against Dillahall and Atkins, that's fine with me. But don't disrespect the organization and try to mock or imitate us, because that's what it looks like. And that's really disrespectful, and especially for the ladies and the females and the guys who like don't care when we like address them on it. That's really disrespectful, because believe it or not, it's going to come back to bite you in the end.
As far as the freshman step teams, I think it's funny. And, you know, honestly, I think it's cool at the fact that, you know, they trying to, you know, have their own thing going on between the dorms. I mean, it gives them something to do. They ain't studying, they doing something. Right. So
some of the freshmen don't have no knowledge about the Greek life and how to go about it.
Yeah.
Especially just walking on the plot. Right. They see it as being, you know, a good thing of art or whatnot, but they don't know the understanding of how we got
yeah.
here.
I wouldn't say they set themselves up for failure. They just showing that they're interested now. You know what I mean? If you was on the freshman step team, it's because you like what we are doing. You know what I mean? So basically, you're showing early interest, which can be good, but at the same time, you don't want to disrespect us. You know what I mean? Saying, oh, so you shimmying now? You know what I mean? So you want to be a cap, you want to be a alpha, and you out there doing your little thing. But, you know, they don't really know. Yeah, they don't know no better. You know what I mean? So that's it is on that.
To be honest, I think the only way that you can set yourself up for failure is by not, you know what I'm saying, striving or trying or making yourself marketable in any aspect. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you got something, like I said, man, if you got it, then you'll get it.
Right.
Like, if you got swag and you want a chick, you'll get it. If you got swag, you know what I'm saying, and swag meaning all aspects of whatever you're approaching, confidence, charisma, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Just the basic things. Pretty much you should understand what I'm saying.
Yeah. So basically, you know what I'm saying, give freshmen, you know, just coming in, ain't really got much to do aside from schoolwork.
Yeah, give them the chance to get known around campus. Somebody be like, yeah, I saw you before, you know what I'm saying? That's, you know, at least have something that you do that somebody can recognize you for.
That's what's up. It kind of didn't come off that way towards the other Greeks, because I know, like, sororities, you know, and frats, you know, they feel some kind of way about everything, to tell you the truth. How do you feel about that?
Well, yeah, it was brought to our attention and stuff, but the reason why we were doing it was because, like, well, I know some people, like, it was a way for, like, we look up to the Greeks. Like, we wanted them to actually see us. We wanted to try to be like them. We wanted to get our faces out. So, like, when we do become juniors or whatever we wanted to, if we wanted to do that, pledge, whatever, like, they can see our face and be like, hey, that's the girl that, you know, she can step in. She's like, I see, like, see what she's doing. So, like, we're just doing to get our face out pretty much and have fun.
So that's why they're doing it. And I think they need to do something else with their time besides stepping.
Right.
When you start doing it, you...
Obviously, I feel like this. If you were for something with a sorority member, you shouldn't feel offended that somebody looks like they're doing something. Like, I'd like to feel like, say, if we had a step, I would want a Q to be offended that it looked like I was swimming when I really wasn't.
Right.
I want to be like, you know what I'm saying? You do that kind of nice. I want to be, you would look like, you know, doing it in a perfect t-shirt. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, I have a little show for it. You know, a little, basically, like, we got pushed to the side or, you know, kicked around
right.
instead of being welcome, which right. is what I thought it would have been.
Not looking at you to see how good you can step, to right. me, is. I'm like, okay, what else
right.
can you do?
Right.
I'm not looking for a stepper. I'm looking for that smart girl in class that's sitting in front.
Right.
I'm looking for that girl that's, they got an amazing video on Ram TV.
Right.
Like, I'm looking for that next leader. I'm not looking for the best stepper, because the best steppers don't graduate college.
I don't know, maybe they need to figure out how to bring down that barrier. So it's not like a we're up here, you guys are down here because you don't have letters kind of thing.
Right.
I don't know, maybe just more activities where it's not worth regular people are standing watching and the Greeks are stepping or putting on some kind of show.
Right.
Maybe something where you collaborate with non-Greeks and Greeks.
One thing I would like to see is for Greeks in general to treat the student body with a little bit more respect than what we seem to be doing right now. Because I understand, you know, you did what you had to do to get, you know, the letters that you wear, but I think more Greeks are starting to let the letters wear them and they're not wearing the letters. So I would like to see, you know, more events for the students. It's nice that, you know, we have things for ourselves, but I think we should really have things for the students.
My biggest thing is, remember what you are before, during, and even after you became Greek, And really, once you do that, you'll remember everything, all your friends and right. stuff like that, because you were a friend before you became Greek.
Right.
Remember all the volunteer hours you did, because you had to have them to become a Greek.
Right.
And remember all of the regular things you did as a person, and then let that define who you are as a Greek. Don't let your letters define you.
Right.
That's all I got.
And yeah.
I feel like we're all adults for one, and that needs to be reminded between everybody. With me being parent president, man, you know, it's a pretty big weight. And at the end of next year, we should not be having the same issues we having now.
I mean, try doing like a big project together where you involve all the Greeks, and it's try doing it so that it's nothing to do with Greeks, but all the Greeks do it together.
All the organizations really need to start doing programs together, more right. programs together, having more outings together. And like really dropping the few that we have.
It's overhyped, right?
It's really overhyped, and I think it's putting on a show for the students.
Right.
And you don't want people to get, if you don't want people coming into your organization, then you need to change yourself, because that's a reflection of yourself.
Right.
And I think everybody needs just to like look at themselves and change something within. It's not everybody else's problem, it's your problem. That's how people see you.
That's what's up.
Look, I ain't talking to nobody in person. I ain't talking to nobody specifically. I'm talking generally.
Right.
Every fraternity, every sorority, they need to get over themselves. If you feel like you better than somebody else because you're a part of the organization, then you need to stop it. All right?
You know what I mean? Just spend some more time together, you know what I mean? And I think that'll be good, and let everybody on the yard know that we're not up here and they down there. You know what I'm saying? I'm cool with everybody. I might not be available to, you know what I'm saying, kick it with them all the time, but at the same time, you know what I mean, I'm cool with everybody. So as long as the campus knows that we're cool with everybody, I think it'll be good.
I think as students, we really need to realize that we all are here for one common goal, and that's to enter to learn and depart to serve. Whether we have letters or whether we don't, that doesn't make us any bigger or better than the next person. So when I look to my left and I look to my right, no matter whether they have letters or not, they are still my brothers and sisters, and we are still trying to make a change.
Thank you for helping me out.
Take the back of the jacket.
Ace.
It's all how you do it. You have to be tactful. I don't like it when girls come up to me and be like, "Hey, aren't you a Delta?" Or, "Hey, why don't y'all step? Why don't y'all step in the show?"
Right.
Don't come up to me like that. That's rude.
You've been here 2, 3, 4 years. Now, if you've been here for that long, and you know on a hot day, you never came up on the plot and sat down underneath a tree, why do it your senior year? Are you trying to make a statement? Let me know.
Yo, is it,
And if you, the viewer, have a problem with this, I feel that you can find me, contact me.
Twitter, Facebook.
Tweet me. Don't poke me though.
You stupid.
336-340-1527. CCOWA826@gmail.com. If you have any questions, you can contact my assistant, Brandon Wilkes.
Hold on, Broderick. There go a Kappa right there.
You gonna say that while I'm recording.
I mean, you can edit that out.
My last question.